The art of parties. Burning. Burning. I'm sorry, it's so catchy. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. I hope that you're having a lovely day. My name is Justin, and today we are listening to Japan with Swing off of their album, Gentlemen Take Polaroids, released in 1980. To be honest, I almost just listened to this album straight through on my own, but then I figured, you know what, let me save a little bit, let me bring it to the channel, because you guys know I love David Sylvian, and I almost just put this on my own, just listened to it, but I figured I might as well bring a little bit to you guys. So I figured we'd do this track, Swing. I have been listening to Tin Drum for just countless times in the past few weeks. I've probably listened to that album, I don't know, at least 30 times in the past few weeks. So it is so ingrained in my head. I just recently was watching over the past few days David Sylvian's concert that he did in Rome in 2001. I would pay exuberant amounts of money to see David Sylvian live. You guys have no idea. Anyways, let's do the song. Hope you're having a wonderful day. Thank you so much for being here. Let's do it. This is Japan with Swing.
Yeah. accents.
I think you guys kind of have an idea, but let me just explain. Listening to David Sylvian, listening to Japan, makes me so unabashedly happy. I feel so good when I listen to the music. You guys know David Sylvian is my favorite artist, right? Like, I can't help it. No matter what kind of mood I'm in, even if I'm not in a bad mood or anything, I could be in the greatest mood ever. Listening to David Sylvian just makes it that much better. This song, banging. I love it. I love it. Mick Karn on the bass, he is one of my favorite bassists. I mean, he is just so wavy. On the bass, he just has a certain motion to him. Even when you watch him play, he plays with such style. He's moving across the stage. Like, Jansen on the drums, I think he's an underrated drummer. I think the band as a whole, to be honest, funnily enough, I've been introduced to their solo works before I got into Japan, which I started getting into Japan on this channel, you know? But hearing them now all together with knowledge of their solo works is just glorious. Like, they are a super group. I feel like if they stayed together, they would, oh man, they'd have a progression into, like, the top of, like, art rock or whatever you want to call it. Man, what a super group. And then Barbieri. I love what he comes up with on the keys and atmosphere and just providing a huge mood to the track. Because the song swings, definitely, right? With Jansen and Karn, the song swings. And then David with that deep, sultry voice that just enriches the whole thing. I don't know what to say about it, other than I love it. I put it on my playlist because, you know, belongs there. I have a lot of David Sylvian and Japan on my playlist already. I don't even know what to say. I honestly want to know what you guys think, because I know, like, you know, sometimes I listen to a song and it might be one of your favorite songs ever, and I might be like, oh, it's okay. It's not like one of my favorites or whatever like that. Ain't that's completely fine, you know? Whoops, I just hit the microphone. My enjoyment of the music or my of songs or whatever, my enjoyment is not faltered or wavered if anyone else doesn't enjoy it. I don't, it doesn't matter to me. I can like Mike Oldfield and Tyler the Creator and All Shall Perish all in the same breath. Doesn't even matter. Three completely different things. It's cool with me. But Japan, David Sylvian, as well as everybody else, they're in. Listen to how Karn's bass sounds like someone zipping up their suit. There's such a glamour to it. And the effects from Barrieri, you know, the echoey fade in, of course the keys. Yeah, that's awesome. Of course David comes in. Look how he bounces with Karn. David's rich, textured voice, along with Karn's moving bass, just works so well together. I mean, really everything does, but just as a standout in this particular track of Healy. He's just riding that wave. He's the surfer. I almost said Karn's the shark, but a surfer doesn't prefer to ride the shark. As far as I know, they ride the wave. And Mick's wave is tidal. I like that kind of carnival-ish whistly sound of the keys from Barbieri. I want to listen to this little song. That's good. That's awesome. I don't know what else to say, to be honest. That is... It just makes me happy. There's nothing I need to say. It's just music that makes me happy. And I am very happy now. Let's talk about the lyrics. Tell me when the work is done. Tell me when the day is through. And I'll drive safely inside my car, taking islands in Africa. Shout if someone gets too near. I'll know just what I ought to do. And I'll arrive safely in my car, taking islands in Africa. Now your feet are back on the ground. Again, she'll say the weather's dim. But relax, my love. Relax and swing and swing. When I see that, she'll say the weather's dim. Like, it's kind of dreary outside, kind of blah outside. So maybe we should stay inside. And he says, relax, my love. Relax and swing. Just swing. Stay with me. We'll swing together. Things you say are not too clear. I'm someone you'll neither know nor care. But I'll sit here, and watch from afar, taking islands in Africa. We need to figure out what exactly he means when he says taking islands in Africa. He could just be talking about traveling with someone he loves as well. Taking Islands in Africa is the last track on this album, which is interesting. Okay. And I'm just looking through the lyrics. I haven't heard this song, but I'm looking through the lyrics of Taking Islands in Africa. And it seems like it's a little like more of an ending, obviously, to the album. But he's talking about sunsets, coming home, the world is waiting, I'll take it by storm. Watch the slow boat hit and run, every day the sun beats down. I pull away from shore, the wind blows hard into my sails. Almost like swing was metaphorically them coming to Africa, or perhaps beginning and embarking on this romantic adventure. And then the final song, Taking Islands in Africa, is the ending of that adventure, the sunset of that. And he's moving on because he says, I pulled away from shore, the wind blows hard into my sails. Makes sense, like, thematically within the album, as Swing, you know, it's the second track in the album. Taking Islands in Africa is the last track. I don't know. Either way, I love the song. Let me know what you guys thought, though. Twitter, definitely join me in the comments. You guys know I love to talk about Sylvian. I almost said Salvian. What kind of country accent is that? Oh, you can also join me on Patreon and all that cool stuff. But have a fantastic day. Thank you so much for bearing with me, fanboying over here. I'm going to fanboy about Sylvian. Can't help it. Can't stop me. You actually can't stop me. But have a wonderful day. Have a beautiful morning. Great night. Whatever it may be. Take a sip of this before. Hold on. Before you go. Caffeine hits just the spot. And I'll talk to you tomorrow.